guys, it's your girl Ashley Kirkwood with the Speak Your Way to Cash podcast, where we teach you how to start at the top of the speaking market instead of working your way up from the bottom. During this show, you will hear solo episodes from me, where I'll show you how I have landed and negotiated 5- and 6-figure speaking contracts and licensing deals. You'll also hear from our amazing guests who have grown enormous speaking businesses by utilizing sales and marketing principles that work. If you want to grow your speaking business, listen to this podcast, and then afterwards, head on over to AshleyNicoleKirkwood.shop and grab my book, Speak Your Way to Cash, How to Start at the Top of the Speaking Market Instead of Working Your Way Up from the Bottom. Ready to dive in? Let's go. Hey, y'all. What's up to the Speak Your Way to Cash family? It's Ashley Kirkwood back again with another podcast episode. But this time, guys, I am actually going to let you listen in to a live video that I recorded. Now, if you're listening to this live video on the podcast and you're like, oh, I want to join your next live, I want to ask you questions, I want to be able to get feedback about my business, then you have to follow me on Instagram at The Ashley Nicole Show and make sure you're following the Speak Your Way to Cash Facebook page, all right? Make sure you're following the Speak Your Way to Cash Facebook page because that's where I go live. I also sometimes go live in the Speak Your Way to Cash Facebook group, but enough about that. Even though you may have missed it live, you're about to hear it again. So listen into this live episode and let me know what you think. You can always send me an email to ashley@speakyourwaytocash.com. Let's listen in. So here's the thing. I did an amazing virtual book tour today with Stan Pearson that was fire. You have to go check that out on his business page. Also, I woke up this morning and let me tell you all the first thing that I read. I'm going to go, because I've never actually done this before on a live, but I'm going to tell you all one of the first things that I read on social media this morning. And it was so powerful that I was like, dang, this is so good. I actually need to share this and I don't want to butcher it. So I want to quote her correctly. So let me see if I can pull it up. It looks like I'm going to be able to pull it up. Yes. Okay. So I logged into social media this morning, minding my good business. And this was the most, it was like, I read this almost instantly. After coming on Instagram to do my post for the day, etc. When you pay for a program, and this is from Jasmine Womack. Her Instagram name is at the Jasmine Womack. Okay. When you pay for a program and half, this is what she said. I didn't say it. So y'all can't get mad at me. Okay. This is what she wrote. When you pay for a program and halfway show up, don't do the assignments, are afraid to ask questions, allow your pride to get in the way, refuse to connect and build relationships with others, then it's not the program that doesn't work. You just didn't work it. I was like, well, hello, good morning to you too, my good sister, okay? I read that this morning and it got me to thinking because I have these conversations with my friends in the industry, my friends who own businesses, who coach people all the time. And I was talking to a great friend of mine and we were discussing accountability and coaching and what that looks like. And, you know, I was telling her that I've joined some programs where I didn't implement the exact strategy of the coach because personally, I believe that's not what you're supposed to do. I think you're supposed to learn from what they do. And then you take the pieces of it that are relevant to you and you put your own spin on it because you yourself are a powerful, innovative creator and thinker. So it's important that you don't go to coaches and look for things that are cookie cutter. That's not what I do. I go to coaching, I get ideas, take the idea and I flip it, right? And I've made some investments that I were like, I really didn't need to make that investment. What I've never done though, is not recouped my investment by way of ideas or relationships or community. And that leads me to this point. My secret business weapon, the thing that has really, really helped me to be successful over the years is this. It's accountability. Let me say it again. My secret business weapon that has helped me to be successful over the years, that has helped my business to grow over 400% each year we've been in business is accountability. And I want to read a piece of the book, Speak Your Way to Cash, How to Start at the Top of the Speaking Market versus Working your Way Up from the Bottom, because there's a piece of the book that deals not directly with accountability, but it deals with a mindset that I think holds people back from being accountable. So only keep watching if you're willing to go somewhere that a lot of people aren't willing to go. And it's to a place of self-reflection. Only keep watching if you're willing to go with me to a place of self-reflection. And I haven't always been great at this. I haven't always been able to utilize this skill. And we'll give y'all a tip or something you can implement a little bit later. But I want to read this portion of the book and I'm on page 13 of Speak Your Way to Cash, the book, which is now available for pre-order. But here's what it talks about. And let me see where I'm going to start. Okay. I'm going to read a couple of sentences, and then we're going to talk about this secret business weapon and five steps to implement it in your business so that you can have unimaginable success. Have you ever heard people say what they made speaking at a virtual event and said, wow, I could never make that? Well, that's what I call divorcing yourself from success. The truth is the first strategy I'm going to give you to build confidence is to stop divorcing yourself from success. When you see anyone doing something you want to do, I want you to say, wow, if that person can do it, I can do it. Find commonality with successful people. I often use this example, and it's a bit dramatic, but it's true. If I wanted to start a large tech company, like something that rivaled Facebook, I would look at Mark Zuckerberg and say, if he can do it, I can do it. Why? Well, we have some commonalities. We're both human. We both bleed red blood. We both attended college, and the list can go on and on. Do you see what I did there? I found commonality with someone that many would think is quote unquote better than them. Let me be the one to tell you that not a single person walking this planet is better than you. Not one. People just make different decisions. They might have a different path, but you determine your choices. Make choices for which your future will thank you. Reading this book is a good place to start. That's just an excerpt. That's some good stuff, okay? Not just because I wrote it, but because it's so powerful if you really learn to implement this strategy of accountability. Now, let's talk specifically about divorcing yourself from success and how that literally impedes your ability to get more out of life. This feels, let me say this, because I know some people believe, you know, when you talk about mindset, when you talk about these things, it can be fluffy. Like, oh, that's fluff. That doesn't really matter. I can tell you for sure, every seven-figure earner, every person who's built a seven-plus-figure business, seven, eight, nine, 10, all those people work on their mindset religiously and intently. We have, you all know, I do a group coaching program, and we're going to do it maybe even the last round next year, but we're going to do it one more time at least in some capacity. And we had someone come and speak to our speakers who is a legend in the speaking business. His name is Jim Cathcart. He has done over 3,800 paid professional speeches. Not only that, he's done it all, has written several books, was the president of the National Speakers Association, has been speaking for more than 50 years, more than five decades, and he still loves what he does. When he was telling them how he built his speaking business, he very clearly explained what he focused on first was reading books on mindset, not strategy, not tips, not sales, not any of that. It was mindset. I talked earlier to Stan Pearson, who's someone I greatly respect in the speaking industry. And what he asked me was like, what do you say to the person who's like, I don't believe you can make six or seven figures from speaking? What do you say to them? And I told him, you know, one of the greatest lessons my father taught me, who is my dad, is someone who went from the projects to literally building a seven plus figure business in the 90s, doing mortgages and real estate and all that. So one of the things that he taught me was like, if you're down to your last $5, what you have to do almost immediately is change your environment so you can see more and therefore you can be more. But like, it sounds cliche, but he literally was like, if I'm down to my last $5 or $10, I would go to one of the nicest hotels in the city of Chicago. I would always get a seat by the window and I would order coffee. I could afford the coffee. And what he would do from there is he would dream his way out of his situation. He would literally think his way out of his situation. He would pray. He would get recentered. But what's important about that isn't so much that he, you know, ordered coffee. It was that he changed his environment so that he could change his thoughts, so that he could change his actions. What a lot of people do is when they're in a bad environment, when they're in a depressing environment, when they're in a sad situation, they immediately go and try to find like-minded people, people who are in the exact same or a similar situation so that they can swap stories of grief. That's not good. And it's not helpful. And if you don't have a perspective that pushes you, you'll never be able to implement the strategies that I teach. I work with so many speakers. I see so many brilliant people. And I know y'all are brilliant. I know you are exceptional. The number one differentiator between my client who landed six plus figures, the client who landed $50,000+, the client that landed $20,000+, the client that went from 20K in her speaking business all year to over 200K in her speaking business in a year. The biggest difference between those folks and people who I see who don't get results, don't get financial results in the programs that we work with is their ability to ask. Now, here's what I want to tell you about an ability to ask. Your ability to ask someone to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars with you confidently And slowly, why do I say slowly? Because what some people do is they're like, well, I asked. No. Did you lead a conversation and show the client the transformation, or did you rush to get it out because you were insecure about the ask? It's not just what you ask. It's also about how you ask. It's the intent with which you ask. And it's the belief behind the ask that leads people to buy. It is not about the strategy for most of you. I will give you all next level brilliant strategies. But before you implement that strategy, what you'll say to yourself in your thoughts is like, I can see how that could work for her, but I don't think that could work for me. Or what some people do, which is even more crippling to your business. For those of you that get this, this one live will change your life. Let me just be very clear and plain about that. So I would recommend you share it with your friends. What some people will do that's even more crippling to their business than failing to ask is they will systematically divorce themselves from the success they're praying for. And this is how they do it. They write up the email, but they don't send it because they're like, I don't know about this email. Or, yeah, I joined the program, but it was just too much work. Or, I mean, I read the book, but like, I didn't see enough examples. Or, I mean, I went to the event last year, but I didn't really get everything that I needed. I mean, that stuff wouldn't really work for me. Let me be very clear about what people do to literally protect their pride. What people do to protect their pride is they systematically and strategically use external excuses to validate their inaction. Let me repeat that. What people do to protect their pride is they systematically and strategically use external examples. They use external factors, external things that they have no control over to protect themselves, to validate their inaction. I just want to talk to some people that are down to like look on the inside. You know what I mean? To look on the inside, because here's the key. This is where people miss it when it comes to confidence. They think, oh, you know, I'm a very confident person, so it's not my fault. That's not how it works. Confident people, like I'm a confident person. That means I could literally go and talk to someone who's brilliant and be like, I don't know what you're talking about. Can you re-explain that to me? Can you break that down? I'm not worried about looking dumb because I'm really seeking knowledge for real, not to look any kind of way to anyone else, but to be. Confidence is about being something. It's not about having stuff and doing stuff. It is about who you are, so that when life comes at you, because it will, when life comes at you and says, you're not pretty enough, you're not smart enough, your kids aren't in a school district where they can provide, your husband is doing all manner of things around here. And so, yeah, you ain't nothing. Like when life comes at you with situations that are external, that are outside of your control, who you are keeps you grounded. Not what you have, not what they said about you, not any of that. It's who you are. So while some people seek knowledge to gather stuff, to get more money, to make more money, there is a certain segment of society that seeks knowledge to become something greater. And it is only when you seek knowledge to become something greater that your life really radically changes. Because guess what, y'all? It doesn't matter how much stuff you have, life can take it. Sorry. I know that we like to believe that if God is the Almighty and if we do everything right, hard times won't come. They will. They will, which is why a part of my mission in this earth is to teach true confidence to people so that they can become something different. And so while there are a lot of people that get caught up in coaching programs to learn a particular strategy, you need to be connected to a coach or a person who is always becoming better so that hopefully they can impart wisdom into you and you can become something different. I'm not trying to get more money in your bank account just so you can have more money. It's about who you become when asking people to respect you by way of paying you your rates. Because really, it's disrespectful to charge beneath the level of transformation that you provide. And what you do when you consistently do that is you invite people to disrespect you by way of underpaying you. And then because you want to blame external factors on who you are, on why you are where you are, you then will start to blame your clients for doing what you've invited them to do. I pay the rates people give me. I'm not in the business of hiring people and then paying them, you know, oh, it's $50 for this book. I'm going to pay $1 million for it just because I have it. No, that's not how it works. People pay what you ask them to pay. And when you have a for-profit business, it is integral that your pricing structure is set up in such a way that you are not inviting these corporations to disrespect you, particularly as a person of color. Can we just say that? Because honestly, there were times where we could not ask. There are some historians that believe that slaves were beat more for speaking than anything else. It is critical that I use my voice in the way that I'm using it, because there are people like in my lineage that would have been killed for speaking up. We're not there now, for the most part. I say for the most part because y'all know, you know, sometimes there are still consequences, right? But we're not there now. It's not as life-threatening now for me to be bold, for me to be proficient, for me to push back, and for me to have personal accountability, so that when I show up as a coach, a consultant, a speaker, or a trainer in a large organization, I can then hold them accountable because I'm paid to do that. Does that make sense? So my personal life's mission as a coach is not just to teach you strategies. It is to help you become who you need to be to dominate in the earth. Let me say it very clearly. What I do is I help the people who are ready to become who they need to be to get there. Everyone is not ready. How do you know you're ready? Because you're willing to analyze yourself. So let's talk about the five phases of fierce accountability. Let's talk about the five phases of fierce accountability, because this is where I needed to get. And there are times in your life where you do complain or you do want to blame other people. And I've been there. And I even talk about in the book, this manager that I had that told me my presentation was amazing, but I show up to the event to present and everyone else's presentation is way better than mine. Initially, I was mad at her. Like, why would you have me show up saying that it was good, knowing good and well that it was not going to pass muster? But inevitably, I had to look at myself. I had to take personal accountability. So let's talk about five phases of fierce accountability. And shout out to Jasmine for that amazing Instagram quote. Number one is analyze. Analyze. Analyze the why, analyze the where, analyze the who. Why did I make the decision that has me in my current circumstance? Like, for real. And this analyzing why typically comes with therapy. I have a therapist that I meet with monthly. And when life got wild for me, when life felt uncontrollable for me, when life felt like it was going to, that it had the potential to take me someplace I didn't want to be, I met with my therapist weekly. It is a sign of self-respect to hire a competent therapist to walk you through your why. It is here. The Speak Your Way to Cash book is now available for you to purchase. Go to Amazon to get your audio, Kindle, or hardcover copy of the book. And we have a paperback copy. Okay. So you can get it on Audible and listen to it. And I read it myself. So if you love the podcast, you will love the audiobook. Go get it now. Speak Your Way to Cash, how to start at the top of the speaking market instead of working your way up from the bottom. A bit about the book. It's broken down into six parts and it is over 260 pages of goodness. Okay. Part one covers mindset. Part two covers getting yourself in the press. Part three covers assembling your six-figure offer. Part four covers inviting people to work with you, sales. Part five covers delivering an outstanding speech. And part six covers legalities that every speaker needs and how to build a team. I mean, literally, what did we leave out? Nothing. So go to Amazon and grab your copy today. And let me know you did it too. Because here's what happens. Life moves fast. I listened to a study. I was listening to Oprah's Super Soul Sunday, and it was about the power of stillness. And the expert that she had on said that it actually takes 27 minutes to recover from a phone call. 27 minutes to recover from a phone call. But what he said was, because of the way life moves now, everything being instant, people messaging you right away, you feeling like you have to respond right away, emails moving at the speed of light. We are moving as a society at the speed of light. And we need to be moving at the speed of life. He was like, really? We should be moving at the sway of the trees, but we're trying to keep up with these machines, the internet, social media, et cetera. Why do I bring that up when talking about analyzing? The way that you can analyze why you make certain decisions will likely involve a high level of self-reflection. And it may take a therapist guiding you through your childhood and different things to figure out, well, why do I do things that? Why do I respond that way? Why does that hurt me? Is it am I really offended or did I learn that offense? And where did I learn that from? You have to be willing to analyze. First step of fierce accountability. Someone, if you can, write that in the chat. That's step one. We got four more great steps. Step two is forgive. Step two is forgive. A lot of times we go through situations in life and we carry that anger like forever. And the anger is making the decision for us about what we're going to do next. So I've talked to people, I've been selling for a while to consumers and to corporations. And on both sides, I've had corporate clients say, oh, well, we hired another speaker and it was awful. Okay. The technology wasn't good. They weren't professional. They weren't prepared. So now we've lowered our speaking budget. We're just not going to put as much money there. Or I've had colleges say that. They've had people show up and it was horrible. So now they need to see five videos. They need X amount of referrals. They only hire people who are recommended. And so really, when you think about that, is it fear making the decision or or not? Like, what's making the decision? Because it is possible that if you don't analyze your why, like, what didn't you? Because really, if you make a bad decision and you analyze the why, you can course correct. You can fix the bad decision for the future. But two, you have to forgive. Forgive yourself for making the bad decision and move on. And after you forgive yourself, then it comes to the rebuilding. The rebuilding. Forgiveness is really important before you rebuild if you're going to have fierce accountability, because if you, like, on the consumer side, we hear people say, oh, well, I hired another coach and I got nothing from it. Well, why? Why did you get nothing from it? Because obviously you hired that particular person because they had something that you desired. What questions didn't you ask that you should have asked to get something from it? You see what I'm saying? Like, what? Come on. So you got to forgive yourself for making whatever bad decisions you may have made. But then it comes to the rebuilding. You have to keep making decisions and quickly. If you still need information, coaching or studying, those are your ways to getting it. Coaching, you hire someone who's already done it, you ask the right questions, you get the information you need, or you go through an established program. Or two, you're going to have to study on your own, self-study, so that you can understand exactly what you need to do. And then after you self-study and you get a lot of information on your own, then you go to coaching and now you know which questions you need to ask because you've done your own research. That's for sure a smart way to go too. But studying and coaching, I mean, that's what you're going to have to do. Like, those are the two ways that you're going to rebuild. Then you got to reflect. And we're talking about the five stages of fierce accountability. Reflect. What went right? What went wrong? What did I learn? Because if all you learned is that you don't like a particular learning style, then that's a lesson that you learned by way of that coaching program. If all you learn is that you like to be in programs that have, you know, some programs are all women. You're like, maybe I want to be in a program with gender diversity. If you learn that, that's a lesson that you learned that you can take from that coaching program. If all you learned is that I need to ask more questions so that next time I have an opportunity to work with someone, I know exactly what to do, then that's a good thing to learn from that program. It takes you being able to reflect, not from a place of anger, because you've already forgiven yourself and whoever else wronged you in the process, for you to really get something good out of this situation, okay? Then after the reflection, you're going to have to take the win. Take the win. This is the last piece of it. Take the win. That's number five. Now, here's what I mean by taking the win. I cannot think of a situation I've been in life where I did not learn something from it. I literally can't think of one. I cannot think of one. So take the win. Take the win. And here's why you have to take the win. And I literally wrote this down so I would not misquote it. Take the win so your memory doesn't prohibit your future. Listen to this. Take the win so your memory doesn't prohibit your future. I have been through some really interesting things in my life. Some of them not great. Like, I don't even talk about some of the things that I've been through in my life, and they weren't great. But even through those things, when I go back and I think about them in my memory, I have developed a narrative of what I have been through that will serve my future. Because if I don't, the bad things that have happened in the past, the people that have wronged me in the past, the jealousy I've encountered in the past will prohibit me from building long-lasting, successful relationships. And at the end of the day, that only hurts me. So you need to take the win in every situation. Whether you may have learned that that was a person that you don't need to be involved with, well, God bless that. Because if you learn that, then that means you can make better decisions for your future, for your children, for your life. That's amazing. Take the win. You spent money with the coach, you didn't like the program, well, great. Now you know what to look out for next time. take the win. Because sometimes you could join a coaching program, not love it, but you develop a friendship from it. Excellent. Take the win. You develop the what? And what is a friendship worth? It's like literally worth more than money can buy. So excellent. You got something priceless out of it. Phenomenal. Take the win so that your memory doesn't prohibit your future. There are some people that I talk to knowing that I'm who they're supposed to work with, but they're like, because I worked with somebody back in the day and it wasn't good. And so what happens is you don't even trust yourself to make a good decision in the future because of what happened in the past. That memory of your past is literally prohibiting your future. I don't know nothing about who you work with in the past, and I personally don't care. I know exactly who I am and exactly what I can do for the right person. I also don't accept everyone. I have refunded some people. I refund. I'm like, oh, this is not for you because I am not a slave to money, period. If it's not a good fit, it's not a good fit. If you're someone who's going to be stressful and all of that, it's not a good fit. I won't, you know, we don't need to work together. So that said, I've encountered women and men and people who have decided because of a past experience with someone else, not related or affiliated with me at all, they won't make another buying decision because they're so scared that they're going to make a bad decision. And really what that tells me is you don't trust yourself. You don't trust yourself. Absolutely. Someone said, I've learned from you. Yeah, I say this all the time. Money is a tool, not a measuring stick. Whether I have a whole lot of it or a whole little bit, or I don't got a lot of it at the moment, that doesn't determine who I am. And really, because it's a tool, you should be utilizing it to become something different than you are, something better, something more fulfilled, something like that's what I use money for. We go on vacation to rest so my mind can rest, so I can dream, so I can be a better person, so I can be a more present wife. I hire coaches for ideas so my mind can go places that it otherwise would not go. I go to events. I spend money on getting VIP tickets to places so that I can go somewhere and feel what it feels like to be catered to and served. I don't like going places sitting in the back. That's not my position in life. I don't like that. I work hard, so I'm going to go and I'm going to sit in the front. We go to a hotel and we want a suite. I'm going to get the suite. Like, I use money as a tool to put me in environments that I want to be in, that have the ability to stretch me. Like that. That's how I use money. That's how I use money. I don't use it as a measuring stick. I don't meet people who have a lot of money and I'm like, oh my God, I need to like pay 500 grand for a dinner with you. I don't know you. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know if we have the same belief system. It's great that you got money, but the truth is it matters to me how you got it too, to be honest. So that is why I don't look at every rich person as a moral or a great person. And I don't look at every person without money as someone who is immoral or doesn't, you know, doesn't have something in life. I can learn from any and everyone. But even to do that, you have to be accountable fiercely. You have to be fiercely accountable. This isn't about like, oh, I don't, you know, well, she didn't give me what I needed. Did you take advantage of all the opportunities that you had available to you? Did you do that? Oh, you didn't do that? Oh, did you develop deep relationships with the other people in your program? Oh, you didn't talk to them? Did you ask astute questions to the person that you hired to give you knowledge and information? Oh, no, you didn't do that. Did you do the activities that they prepared for you? Oh, no, didn't do that. So where is the personal accountability? Because what I hear from people is like, well, I don't even need that. I don't need that portion of it. So I just skip that. But how do you know? Because you didn't go through it. And here's the other thing. If you decide not to go forward with a particular thing, if you decide not to take advantage of every opportunity to learn, if you decide not to give it your all, that may be a strategic decision, but do not complain about your results. Because I've gone through things and been like, oh, this part is for me. This part isn't for me. But what you'll never hear me doing is complaining about the results. And when the person who I've hired says, you know what, there was a portion in chapter 5 you didn't really check out, you need to go and check that out. I'm going to check that out. I need something in module 5. Like, I'm gonna go check that out. You know what I'm saying? So you just have to be really careful about your level of accountability. It's critical. That is my secret business weapon, is being accountable, being willing to, being open-minded to the fact that I could be wrong and admitting it and then dealing with the backlash of it and then moving on. Because here's the other thing we do. Sometimes you'll realize, dang, I am wrong. Dang, I didn't do that. And you start getting down on yourself. No. Mm-mm. So you want to be very, very, very clear that you are not someone who's not being accountable. Like, you have to have accountability. You have to implement fierce accountability. So number one, stop divorcing yourself from success. Number two, implement fierce accountability in your life. There are five steps that we talked about today. One, analyze the situation. Two, forgive yourself. Forgive yourself for whatever it is that got you where you are. Three, rebuild. Rebuild. Rebuild after forgiving. Rebuild after forgiving so that you can make clear-headed decisions about your future. Four, reflect. Reflect on what happened from a position of power. And five, take the win. In every situation, depending on your perspective, there is a way to get a win out of it. You have to take the win so that your memory does not prohibit your future. I do hope this information was valuable to you. It was helpful. You got something out of it. And if you're someone who's like, I'm accountable, I'm ready to go to the next level, I'm ready to dream bigger than I've ever dreamt before, I want to start selling to corporations, I want to develop my skill of sales in a way that is significant to my business, then I want to see you at Speak Your Way to Cash Live 2021. Now look, y'all, this particular event is very unique. Everyone who gets their ticket this month, you have like 17 days left to get your ticket for this. You get your ticket this month and you will get this workbook that I'm holding in my hands for those of you who are watching. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about the sessions. We have Getting Your Mind Right, Goal Setting for Powerful Speakers, a Dreamer's Den, where we're going to take you through a visualization strategy that will help you to dream bigger than you've ever dreamt before about your business, mastering the corporate landscape, building your framework and positioning your solution for profit, pricing pathology, setting and framing your price to serve you and your client, exploding your brand with TV exposure, developing a hot list of future clients, assembling your six-figure package, pitching to corporations with ease, a language lab where we'll actually give you the language and the skills that you should use during different situations on your sales call. So like if there's a timing objection, what do you say? If there's a value objection, what do you say? And we give you that on page 29 of the workbook. The possibilities panel, you'll hear from some of my clients and how they've grown their businesses, delivering an impeccable speech through storytelling, and then implementation secrets, how to put it all together. 3 days, 13 modules. It's intense. We're going to get through everything. We're going to change some lives. And for those of you getting your in-person VIP ticket, let me tell you, we capped it at like 25. So each person will have 6 feet. We rented a 3,000 square foot venue. Every person will have 6 feet between themselves. You'll have to show a negative COVID test before attending, regardless of vaccination status. Like, we're even thinking of having on-site testing, but we're still working that out. So either way, we're going to take all the COVID protocols we need to take. We rented a huge space for a small amount of people so that we can all have our socially distanced event. And it's a really beautiful hotel around really good food and shopping and all that fun stuff. It's a good area. But yeah, this is a next level event. This is where you come when you're ready to dream big, when you're ready to implement big, when you're ready to take some action, and when you're ready to stretch yourself and get in an environment that can accommodate big dreaming, that can accommodate big thinking. Because I don't know about you all, but not every environment accommodates that. You can be who you are in any environment, but not every environment is ready for it. Not every environment is gives you the space to do it. That's what we're creating, is a space for you to do it. Yes, Grace, I'm so glad you got your VIP ticket. Can't wait to meet you. But yeah, so that's what I have for you all today. Fierce accountability. We got to be accountable in order to go to the next level. That is my secret business weapon. Really appreciate you all joining me. And again, go to speakyourwaytocash.com/event to get your tickets to the Speak Your Way to Cash Live 2021. Oh, and all the people attending get advanced reader copies of the book. So definitely, 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 that's what you're going to want to do. So I really, 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 really appreciate that. Appreciate what you all have done. Appreciate your feedback about the live videos. And I will see you guys in November.
All right. Wasn't that interview amazing? If you're anything like me, you have pages full of notes. But here's the thing. Before you head out, I want you to go to Facebook.com and join the Speak Your Way to Cash Facebook group. That is where I am. That's where a ton of other speakers are, a ton of other people who listen to the show. We all congregate there and chat. And it's 100% free. Now, if you're ready to take your speaking career to the next level, I have two ways for you to do that. One, you can go to ashleynicolekirkwood.com/SYWTC live replay and pick up the live replay. That training is 7 modules, chock full of information. It's crazy. Go over there, read all about it. Or if you want a more personal experience, you already know that you want to be a speaker. You're ready to fully commit and you want someone to walk you through it and save you tons of time. Googling and doing it on your own, then book a VIP day with me. You can go to AshleyNicoleKirkwood.com, scroll down until you see the VIP day section, and get more information on that there. All right. Thank you guys again for watching. Please do not forget to leave us a review. That is how we keep this train rolling and get some of the best speakers in the world to get on this show. So please, please, please leave a review. Shoot me a message on Facebook or Instagram, and Facebook in the Speaker Rated Cash group, Instagram at the Ashley Nicole Show. And I'd be more than happy to chat with you and say hi. All right, y'all, have an awesome, awesome day.